यूनिट टू मैग्नेटोस्टैटिक The magnetic field is said to be static field. The magnetic field is said to be static magnetic field whenever it is produced either by the DC current or the permanent magnet. So magnetic field and magnetic field intensity. An important property of magnet is that it attracts ion pieces, but it attracts important property of magnet is that it attract ion pieces, but it attract ion pieces only when they are placed within certain area around the magnet. So the area around the magnet within which its influence exists is called as its magnetic field. And within the magnetic field of magnet, if another magnet is placed, then the other magnet experiences a force. The magnetic field intensity is defined as the force experienced by unit N pole within a magnetic field of magnet, and it is denoted by H. And it is measured in ampere per meter. So if charges are moving with a constant velocity, then a static magnetic or magnetostatic field is produced. Thus, a magnetostatic field originates from the current. For instance, direct current in current-carrying wires. Most of the equations we have derived from for the electric field may be readily used to obtain the corresponding equations for magnetic field if the equivalent analogous quantities are substituted. So the types of current distributions, basically there are two types of current distribution, three types, line current density, surface current density and volume current density. So line current density is current. It occurs for the infinitesimally thin filamentary bodies, that is wires of negligible diameter, and the surface current density, that is the current per unit width, and it occurs when body is perfectly conducting. So volume current density, and the volume current density is current per unit cross sectional area, so it is most general. So the next is Lorentz force. Now here the electric field intensity E bar is defined as the force per unit charge. In physics particularly, the electromagnetism and Lorentz force is the combination of electric and magnetic force. It is the combination of electric and magnetic force on a point charge due to electromagnetic field. So if particle of charge Q mu moves with velocity v in the presence of an electric field E and magnetic field B, then it will experience a force. And the first derivation of the Lorentz force is commonly attributed to the Oliver Heaviside in 1889, though other historians suggest an earlier origin in 1865 paper. So Lorentz force, the electric field intensity E bar is defined as the force per unit charge. So E bar is equal to what? F r by Q, and F r is equal to Q into E bar. Now what is F bar? F r is the force on charge particle. Q is what? Q is charge on the particles, that is coulomb. It is in coulomb. Force is in Newton, charge is in coulomb. And E bar is what? E bar is electric field intensity, which is in volt per meter. So if charge is in motion, then the force acting on it is given by F bar equal to Q into E bar. Now here is the Lorentz force equation is given, Q into E bar plus Q V bar X B bar. So the scientist was born in 18 July 1853. The land died on 4th February 1928. So here is the information related to this scientist. So what is this law? This force is in the same direction as that of the E bar, and it is directly proportional. The force is in the same direction as that of the E bar, and it is directly proportional to both E bar and Q. So consider that the charged particles is moving in a magnetic field having the flux density B bar. So it is experimentally found that the force acting on such a charged particle is directly proportional to the factors. The first is directly proportional to the product of magnitude of charge Q, velocity V bar, and flux density B bar. Second, directly proportional to the sine of the angle, that is the theta, between the vectors V bar and B bar. So F bar is directly proportional to sine theta. So if we say a charge Q resides at point R and it is moving at velocity V. So somewhere other charges and currents have generated an electric field E of R and magnetic field density B of R. And these fields exert a force on charge Q equal to F is equal to Q into E of R plus Vx of Br. And here the force due to ER, that is Fe, could be parallel to the velocity vector V. These fields exert a force on charge Q, which is equal to F equal to Q into ER plus Vx Br. So here the force due to the E of R, that is F, it could be parallel to the velocity vector V. Now, so for that case, ER will apply force on the charge in the direction of its velocity and it will speed up, that is accelerate the charge, essentially adding a kinetic energy to the charge particle. So the force due to ER could be anti-parallel to velocity vector U. For this case, the electric field ER applies a force on the charge in the opposite direction of its movement, and it will slow down the charge, essentially extracting a kinetic energy from the charged particles. So from the equations, the first is directly proportional to the product of the magnitude of the charge Q, its velocity V bar, and the flux density B bar. So F bar is directly proportional to Q into mod of V bar into mod of P bar. Second is, it is directly proportional to the sine of the angle, that is theta, between the vector V bar and V bar. So F bar is directly proportional to sine of theta. Now from so F bar is equal to Q into mod of V bar into mod of V bar sine theta. But according to the definition of cross product, the equation becomes F bar is equal to Q into V bar cross V bar. Now what is F? F is a force which is exerted on a charged particle because of magnetic field. Q is what? Q is charge on particle, which is in coulomb. V is the velocity of charged particle meter per second, and B is magnetic flux density Weber per meter square. So the force on moving particle due to its combined electric and magnetic field, and it is obtained by adding this. So the now the contrast is with the force applied by the magnetic flux density. We have this equation. So the Fm is always orthogonal to velocity vector V, and because as a result the force due to the magnetic flux density can change the direction of the velocity but not the magnitude of velocity. That means The force neither speed up or slow down a charged particle, although it will change its direction. As a result, the magnetic flux density cannot modify the kinetic energy of the charged particle. So, in case of the electric field, the direction of force is not dependent on velocity vector. So, the energy transfer takes place between the electric field and a moving charge. And in case of magnetic field, the direction of force is perpendicular to the direction of velocity vector B bar and magnetic flux density B bar. So, the kinetic energy of the moving charge is not changing. That is, there is no transfer of energy from magnetic field to the moving charge. Now, what are the practical applications of Lorentz force? So, we all are very aware of the practical importance of this law. In fact, we will likely observe its effects several times each day. An almost perfect application of this law is cathode ray tube, that is CRT. So this is a device at the heart of every television and computer monitor. It is a device at the heart of every television and computer monitor, or at least the non-plasma or LED kind. So at the very back of the CRT, that is cathode ray tube, is an element which is heated to very high temperature. And this hot element begins to emit electrons into the vacuum of the CRT. So the cathode ray tube consists of a base focusing system, vertical deflection phosphor created area, electron beam. So at the very back of CRT, an element that is heated to very high temperature, and these hot element begin to emit the electron into the vacuum of the CRT. So the next part is magnetic flux. We will continue it in the next lecture. Thank you.